Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Cadet Captain Abigail Maima, the Regimental Commanding Officer of the Linden High School Navy JROTC program. Welcome to the 112th Commencement Exercises of Linden High School. Will everyone please rise? Leading the procession today, our Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Maureen Hazelton. Assistant Superintendent of Schools, Mrs. Denise Cleary, School Business Administrator, Mrs. Kathleen A. Gaylord, and Director of Human Resources, Dr. Karen Baldwin. Board of Education President, Mr. Carlos Rivas, and board members, Mr. Gregory Martucci, Mr. Patrick Gargano, Mrs. Mary Ann Manginello, Mrs. Sinead Gilliam, Mrs. Malaysia Thomas, Mr. Samuel De La Cruz, and Mrs. Jennifer Fleming. The Honorable Mayor Derek Armstead. And now, introducing the Principal of Linden High School, Mrs. Yelena Horry. Senior Vice Principal and Graduation Coordinator, Mr. Jason Fakiti. Vice Principals, Mr. Frank Bandinelli, Mrs. Lizzie Lemus, and Mr. Kevin Thurston. Also, we would like to recognize Linden School District Administrators, Directors, and Supervisors. Mrs. Michelle Altavelli, Mr. Gregory Grasso, Mr. Christopher Colavis, Mr. Derek Kondrowitz, Mr. Kevin LaMastra, Mr. Matthew Lorenzetti, Ms. Annabelle Lewis, Ms. Antoinette Modrak, Mr. Richard Molinaro, Mr. Joseph Scaldino, Mrs. Jennifer Smith, Dr. Marie Stefanik, Dr. Patricia Tartavita, Mr. Steven Viana, Mr. Michael Walters, and Mr. Kyron Zahir. The Linden High School NJROTC, under the direction of Senior Naval Science Instructor Commander Boyd Decker, is assisting on the commencement field. And now, presenting the graduating class of 2021, led by the senior class advisors, Mrs. Melanie Calatiud and Miss Diana Marchese. Followed by Senior Class President Mackenzie Kuntz, Valedictorian Jordan Loftus, Salutatorian Melissa Menzel, Third Honors Mahmoud Shahada. Also, we would like to recognize Senior Class Vice President Emily Snarkowski, Senior Class Secretary Hadasha Ramirez, Senior Class Treasurer. Mrs. Sylvie Villarino, Ms. Calliope Vitorolis, Mrs. Catherine Volker, Mrs. Ann Zoltachaskiva. Thank you. At this time, I would like to introduce the senior class vice principal, Mr. Jason Fichitti.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Please rise for the presentation of the colors and remain standing for our national anthem. Will the gentlemen please remove their caps and replace them at the end of the national anthem? The national anthem will be performed today by Linden High School seniors Mackenzie Kuntz, Victoria Strzowska, and Emily Schnurkowski. March on the colors. Post the colors. It is my pleasure to introduce the salutatorian of Linden High School, class of 2021, Melissa Menzel.
Will the class of 2021 please be seated? Good evening. My fellow graduates, it is my honor and privilege to be giving you this speech today as your class of 2021 salutatorian. To the families, teachers, staff, administrators, Board of Education members, and guests, thank you for being here with us to celebrate the next step in our future. But before we can celebrate, I would like us to each reflect on this past year and the journeys we all took to get to this momentous day. I want to first begin by acknowledging that this past year has not been easy for any of us. Every single one of us has been impacted in some way by this devastating pandemic. For us students, we all faced obstacles that none of us could have fully prepared for. Whether or not we made it to class on time was at the mercy of our Wi-Fi connection. Many of us had distractions all around us as we logged into WebEx every day. And I'm sure at some point during our virtual learning, we could all relate to the feeling of isolation. Virtual learning was a hurdle of its own, not to mention the unique challenges that we may have faced outside of the school setting. As for myself, I've had my own set of challenges as well. You see, 1 year ago today, I was well into radiation therapy to treat a rare brain cancer I had called germinoma. The journey to my diagnosis of germinoma alone had been a long, emotional, physically exhausting experience. I started experiencing symptoms freshman year, which led to the discovery of a brain tumor sophomore year. Doctors suspected the tumor was cancer, but nothing could be done about it at the time due to the location and size of the tumor. The year that followed this distressing discovery was one of persistent and obsessive thoughts of worry. It wasn't until my junior year of high school, doctors were finally able to confirm from a brutal surgical biopsy that I did, in fact, have cancer. Once I received this diagnosis, something changed in me. I knew what it was like to let the fear of the unknown consume my mind, and it wasn't pleasant. I also knew that things were only going to get worse before they got better. I realized it was time that I changed the way I viewed my adverse circumstance. Otherwise, I would continue to live my days in constant fear. I started to look for things to focus on that would allow me to feel hopeful rather than hopeless. I had to focus on things to be grateful for. It wasn't until I began thinking more positively that I was able to find the motivation and commitment to not give up and to persevere through my hardship. If there's any lesson that I hope can be learned from my experience, it's that in the future you will face plenty of unexpected hurdles that may seem impossible to surmount. How you choose to handle those obstacles will make all the difference in whether or not you will overcome them. When word got out that I was undergoing treatment for cancer, I was given even more reasons to continue to fight. This is because I was overwhelmed with support from friends, family, teachers, classmates, and members of the community, who I would like to take a moment to thank. To my Grandma Rose, Grandpa Paul, and all of my family, thank you for your unwavering love and support. To my parents, I'm sorry for every gray hair that I caused. Thank you for always being there by my side to comfort and care for me. I couldn't ask for better parents. Thank you to my best friend and younger sister, Lauren, for never failing to make me laugh and brighten my day. Thank you to all of my teachers I've had throughout my 4 years of high school, including my amazing IB teachers and especially Mr. Fischetti, who never stopped believing in me. To my outstanding ROTC instructors, Petty Officer O'Neill, Master Sergeant Gombos, Senior Chief DeJean, Chief Velez, and Commander Decker, thank you for teaching me how to be a leader and for encouraging me. Thank you, Ms. Sabayo and Ms. Volker, who were always there for me whenever I needed help. Thank you to the generous organizations that helped me out this past year, such as the Mayor's Youth Commission, Bringing Hope Home, and Make-A-Wish. Thank you to all of the healthcare workers, both locally and especially at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, for the incredible care I received from you. Finally, I would like to thank all of the wonderful parents, classmates, friends, and the community. Because of the kindness, compassion, and support that you've given me, you helped me make it to this day. You contributed greatly to my motivation during treatment and this past school year. Knowing that I had so many people rooting for me and my success was the reason I got out of bed every day. Not only this, but you and the kindness that you've shown me served as my reminder to treat every nurse, doctor, healthcare worker, and stranger I encountered with kindness and greet them with a smile, Even when I was feeling miserable or sick to my stomach. I hope you know that you've truly made a difference in my life. If there's one last piece of advice I want to leave everyone with, it's to try your best to go through life and all of its struggles with as much grace and optimism that you could possibly muster. It's what will help you to see past the hardship you may encounter, to not give up, and to imagine the future that you want to create for yourself. Congratulations, class of 2021. The best of our lives is yet to come.
It is my honor to introduce our mayor, the Honorable Derek Armstead.
Good evening, Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Marnie Hazelton, Assistant Superintendent, Mrs. Denise Cleary, Board President Carlos Rivas, members of the Board of Education, Principal Elena Horry, Vice Principals Jason Fichetti, Lizzie Lemes, Kevin Thurston, and Frank Bandinelli. Parents, guardians, family, friends, faculty, and staff. And last, but certainly not least, the graduating class of Linden High School 2021. Congratulations on this great milestone in your life. To say that it's been an unusual year and a half would be an understatement, maybe even the understatement of the year. And it would be remiss if I didn't mention your prior class of 2020, who suffered just as well last year because of the pandemic. We provided them with an airport graduation, and for a while, I thought we'd have to do the same thing again. But then a glimmer of hope, a light at the end of the tunnel, suddenly appeared. We went from red to orange, orange to yellow, yellow to blue, and a few weeks ago, you were allowed to participate in the normal activity, your senior prom. It gladdened my heart to see you there. At last, things were beginning to return to normal. Thomas Paine once wrote that these are the times that try men's souls. Understand that this pandemic tried all of our souls. And understand that pandemic or not, you were going to have a graduation, and we are here. Many years ago, when I was in junior high school, there was a phrase that was written on one of the walls in my classroom. It read, "The problem is I lived half my life before I realized it was a do-it-yourself job." While I am certain that as you progress in life, there will be individual challenges and your hard work as an individual will pay off. However, this pandemic has certainly proven that those words aren't exactly 100% true. This pandemic has taught us that we have to work together, that the only way that human beings will overcome adversity is through working with each other. You've had to deal with virtual learning and not being able to participate in normal scholastic activities. This, I am sure, was very hard to adjust to. But you did adjust. Thomas Paine also said in that same speech mentioned earlier that he who stands it now deserves the love and thanks of all his countrymen. And you did stand it, and you weathered the storm. I am confident that these lessons that were learned during this pandemic will be carried throughout your life and will make you better. It will make you stronger. I am proud of each and every one of you for never giving up. You should applaud your parents, because behind every successful student, there's a hardworking, loving, and supportive parent or guardian who believes in you and would do anything to see you reach your fullest potential. Your teachers should be applauded, not just the ones you had over the last 4 years, but the ones who taught you throughout your educational journey. So today is not a new beginning, but the next step in your life's journey. Just remember, so many people believe in you, and so much has been invested in helping you succeed. Make your parents proud, make your city proud, but most of all, make yourself proud. Congratulations, Linden High School Class of 2021, and may God continue to bless you on this journey. Thank you.
Linden High School Principal, Mrs. Yelena Jorge, will now come forward to address the class of 2021.
Good evening, parents, staff, esteemed board members, Dr. Hazelton, and most of all, the class of 2021. It is my great pleasure to address you here tonight, class of 2021, at the very first evening commencement ceremony in a very long time. With all you have weathered, you deserve a special send-off. It's been a long and winding road to get us to this point, given the pandemic and all that you have had to endure over the past 15 months. But tonight, we celebrate, in front of family and friends, your incredible accomplishments during the past 4 years, the last two of which have been truly unprecedented. I have been fortunate enough to be part of the inspiring vocation that is education for over 30 years. Up until March of 2020, I honestly thought I understood everything there was to know about teaching and learning. I thought up until then that I had studied and mastered all things concerning education and student experience. I had no idea how wrong I was. Your junior year, some would argue the most critical year of the high school period, was forever changed in March of 2020. Overnight, you had to adapt from face-to-face learning, which you've known your whole life, to distance learning. Teachers and students alike ventured into this unknown virtual world, and yet you all persevered. In addition to your education, many of you took on the challenges of caring for younger siblings, working to support your family, and the anguish of isolation due to COVID-19, and still you persisted. This continued into your senior year. Senior year, which is supposed to be filled with memories and milestones, looked so uncertain for so long, as Mayor Armstead just said. But thankfully, we've been able to enjoy some semblance of normalcy with not only our commencement today, but also a return to in-person learning, prom, and the upcoming summer bash. I've read so much about the loss of learning due to the adjustments that we've all had to make during recent times. Yet, when I reflect upon this idea, I realize how absurd that concept really is. Loss of learning. You've lost nothing. You've gained an incredible amount of empathy, knowledge, and resilience during the past 15 years. You've learned more about yourself, about grit and perseverance, than perhaps any other graduating class. You have learned to push forward and adapt in the face of unparalleled adversity. You've learned to strike a balance between all the responsibilities and difficulties that life can throw at you and still maintain a vision for tomorrow. Most of all, you've learned how precious and valuable life is and how we should never take anything or anyone for granted. The history books will tell your story. They will tell how in the midst of a national pandemic, you, the class of 2021, have risen with a selflessness and compassion that speaks of leadership and strength. You cannot and will not be defined by your circumstance. You will be able to speak someday of the time before the pandemic that stopped the world and all that has happened since, like people speak of before 9/11 and other defining times in history. And you will inspire future generations by sharing your story. There is work to be done, but you will leave us prepared to take up this mantle. Refer to the message left to you by the class of 2015. Their legacy wall reads, "What starts here changes the world." That simple, powerful truth was left for you. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. believed in that power. the power of one person to change the world. He said, "The arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice." It bends towards justice. I know that is true, but it doesn't happen without you, without your voice, without your will and hard work and intelligence and belief in good. Important change cannot happen. You are part of history, part of the story of this extraordinary time of enduring loss and rising above. The class of 2021 has endured and risen. You have not ignored the intolerable justice that permeates our nation, but have raised your voices, acknowledging that there is no neutral position on issues of racial justice. As a class, you will continue to forge the path, demanding change where it is needed, calling out racism in all its forms and eradicating it. You will lead future generations with compassion and strength, asking not, as the proverb goes, for a lighter burden, but for broader shoulders. This world needs you, and there is no greater privilege than to be needed and rise to service. You leave us so very prepared for the challenges that will undoubtedly await you. You leave us better people than when you began your journey here 4 years ago. You leave us as distinguished LHS graduates, ready to lead, change, and improve the world. I am so proud of all that you have done, and I am so ready for the impact that you will have on this world. You inspire me, and it has truly been my honor to be your principal. Congratulations, class of 2021. At this time, we would like to honor our top students. Will the following students come forward to accept their honors from our superintendent of schools, Dr. Marnie Hazelton? First honors, Jordan Loftus. Second honors, Melissa Menzel. Third honors, Mahmoud Shahada.
There are many outstanding groups and organizations at Linden High School that are an intrinsic part of our fabric and significantly enrich student life. We would like to take a moment to recognize the students that comprise each of these prestigious groups and organizations. Students, you may remain seated as we applaud each organization. International Baccalaureate Diploma Candidates. National Honor Society. Peer Group Connection. Peer Pals Leaders. Learn and Serve America. The Distributive Education Club of America, DECA. The Naval Junior Reserve Officer Training Corp, NJROTC. World Language Honor Societies. Thank you. We would now like to recognize the brave men and women of our graduating class of 2021 who will go on to serve in our nation's military. Please stand to be recognized. Will the parents of these students and anyone in the audience that has served in the military please also stand to be recognized? Thank you. Please be seated.
It is my pleasure at this time to introduce the valedictorian of Linden High School, class of 2021, Jordan Loftus.
Teachers and staff, families, friends, and fellow students, thank you for coming to celebrate the graduating class of 2021. It is an honor to be able to give this speech to you all today. I don't like public speaking, so please bear with me. I'm going to be honest. I don't like this, mainly because there are so many other hardworking and intelligent students here who also deserve recognition. But I am very thankful for this title nonetheless. I know a lot of teachers jokingly asked me to include them in my speech, but I would feel terrible if I shouted out certain people and inadvertently excluded others. There is definitely not enough time to do justice to each individual, so I would just like to thank all the teachers and mentors who have supported and inspired me, as well as many other students, to get to where we are today. I would also like to acknowledge and thank the parents and guardians who are here with us, whether that be in person or virtually, including my own, of course. I'm so grateful to my parents and grandparents, as well as my brother Justin, for always being there for me and cheering me on. Mom, it's hard for me to find the words to truly thank you for all that you've done, for the late nights worrying, for driving me and my friends all around, and for just being my person. Each of our families and friends have played a major role in the lives of everyone who is graduating. They have encouraged us and have helped shape us into who we are today. Students, you should be proud of yourselves for coming this far, especially with everything that has happened these past 2 years with the pandemic. Although we were all faced with many challenges, we managed to overcome them, just as we will continue to do in the future. The road ahead is full of uncertainty, but we cannot let this hold us back from reaching our full potential. I would like to share a quote with you that inspires me. It reads, "You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think." You may not believe me when I tell you that this is a Disney quote spoken by Christopher Robin from Winnie the Pooh, but it is. Nothing is impossible, so never say that you can't do something, because you can. With hard work, dedication, and determination, anything is possible. I chose to share this quote in particular with you all, not only because it contains a great message, but because it is a reminder of our youth. It may not seem like it to the parents and teachers gathered here today, but we are about to be adults ourselves. Some of us may already consider ourselves to be adults, but it is perfectly all right to look back and reminisce on our past. However, it is important to remember to not let the past drag you down, but instead to let the future pull you up. We have big things in store for us in this new and exciting time of our lives. Embrace every opportunity, stand up to every challenge, and find joy in all you do. Before I go, I would like to share with you all one last thought. We have probably all heard this saying before, but a new chapter is beginning in our lives as this one ends. We are all the main characters in our own novels. The choices you make now will foreshadow what will happen throughout the many other chapters in your novel. Don't be afraid to have dreams and goals that are difficult to accomplish and achieve. You're the main character of your story, after all, and you will accomplish whatever you set your mind to. If you need help along the way, remember all the supporting characters in your story. They will help fill the pages of your life. The pen is yours, and the story has just begun. LHS graduates, it is time to write your story.
Congratulations, class of 2021. I hope that you are all successful and do well wherever life may take you. Thank you.
Dr. Hazelton, as principal of Linden High School, it gives me great pleasure to present to you the Linden High School Class of 2021.
Thank you, Mrs. Hore. Will the class of 2021 please be seated? Good evening, Linden Board of Education and parents, Mayor Armstead, Linden High School family, friends, esteemed guests, and colleagues. We are gathered here on this impressive field on this beautiful Friday evening to celebrate the graduating Linden High School class of 2021. To call you all survivors would be an understatement. You have thrived, you are resilient, bold, and wondrously made. 16 months ago, your educational careers were upended. However, you met adversity head on and continue to soar. The soft skills that you have honed during the pandemic have made you stronger and wiser. You embrace change, you learn how to pivot on a dime, and you demonstrated strength that you did not realize you possessed. As you move on to the next chapter in your life, treasure the love and support that Linden High School has poured into you all. The staff at Linden High School, led by Mrs. Hore, invested so much in ensuring that you are equipped to conquer the world. Whether you are off to college, the military, vocational school, or entering the workforce, you are ready to face any obstacles placed in your way. You are Linden Tigers. No two tigers have the same stripes. Like human fingerprints, their stripe patterns are unique to each individual. Shout out to Dior, who I just met for the first time, and I'm meeting many of you for the first time. You can hear a tiger's roar from up to 2 miles away. Tigers are keystone species. They're integral to the health of the ecosystems in which they live. So as you set the world ablaze with your roar and your uniqueness like tigers, remember the love that Linden poured into you since you were little tiger cubs. We have prepared you to walk onto any college campus or into any boardroom, equipped with grace, intelligence, dignity, and pride. Step into your greatness. We are all rooting for you. Once again, congratulations, job well done. This is your night to celebrate safely with family and friends. And Jordan and I are in sync. You quoted Winnie the Pooh, I'm going to quote Dr. Seuss. Dr. Seuss, for many of you, Dr. Seuss was your first introduction to reading. So I will leave you with a full circle quote from Dr. Seuss's, "Oh, the places you'll go." Kid, you'll move mountains. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. So get on your way. God bless and the best of luck to all of you. Mr. Rivas, Board President, as Superintendent of Schools, it gives me great pleasure to present to you the Linden High School class of 2021.
Thank you, Dr. Hexeton. It is an honor. Would the class of 2021 please seat? Good evening, Board of Education. Mayor Amstead, Linden High School family, friends, esteemed guests, and colleagues. We're gathered here on this impressive field on this beautiful Friday evening to celebrate the graduating Linden class of 2021. It is an honor for me as the board president to speak for all the members here joining me here this evening to say that this is a part of this memorable and historical moment in our lives. You have worked very hard. You deserve to be celebrated today. Life is a journey that we all experience differently. Not one person is the same as another, but many of us search similar purposes in life. I have no doubt that for every parent here today, one of those purposes is to witness our children succeed in their high school education as they reach this incredible milestone. We all hard work diligently through these unprecedented COVID times, and I am sure for all of our students, it has been one of the toughest experiences they have ever endured so far. But each one of us and each one of you, together with your loved ones, have made it through during this unparalleled storm. As I look into the crowd tonight, I see faces from many different backgrounds, many different walks of life. And it takes me back when I embarked in my journey 30 years ago to America. I arrived here as a graduate student, not speaking a word of English, but committed to overcome any obstacle I could face. It was a challenging time in my life, but I knew that I have to adapt to change. Similarly, and just like you all have done through this COVID pandemic times. You went from going to in-person learning to remote and virtual learning, having to constantly adapt to the effects of the latest health crisis and finally get to the place that we now call our new normal. I cannot imagine how difficult it must have been for you not to practice your favorite sport, not to gather with your friends, not to attend the activities that you normally enjoy. But as I mentioned, regardless of the challenges in front of you, you have shown yourself to be resilient through all this entire process. I would like to invite your families and friends here today to please rise and salute you with a round of applause, because we feel very proud of you. To all of you whose first language is for many of you sitting here this evening, English is your second language. And as you enter this new phase of your life, it might be not easy, but also it won't be impossible. There will be many who will perceive this language barrier as a weakness, but you will turn it into an opportunity where there will be no closed doors or no glass ceilings. To all of you whose language of first language is English, there also will be challenges. As well as many of you, this can make you break you or make you in life, but you will persevere. What I'm saying is to never give up. There will be undoubtedly tough moments in your life, but there will also be great moments. And when you face those tough moments, never give up. Do not be afraid to turn to someone to help. Stick to your core values and always, always be respectful to each other. Please never forget that the recognition and honor you achieve on your graduation today is the result of your hard work, determination, perseverance, and it will surely be a great feeling once you know that all your sacrifices were worth it. The results are more than what you expected. These achievements not only will make your loved ones proud, but more importantly, it will impress each one of you of the way of what are you capable of doing. To all the parents and guardians today, you have done a tremendous job. I can't avoid mentioning how our lives changed quickly in a matter of an instant. We became teachers and guidance counselors while at the same time continue to handle the pressures of work and family. I sincerely tip my hat to all of you. I'm also a parent of two children, and I understand how these unprecedented times had touched our lives. Graduating students, now I ask you to stand with me and give your families a round of applause. They deserve them. They're the heroes here tonight as well. You may be seated. Finally, I want to thank you all for having me here this evening. It will always be an honor for me to serve you as a board president. We're happy this evening to celebrate together with you and your families your academic achievements, as well as your numerous accomplishments. I am confident that each one of you will make your mark in the world. Again, we all feel very, very proud of you. Congratulations, Linden High School of 2021. Thank you.
Each year, the Board of Education presents a special award to the top five students in each area of study. Board President Mr. Carlos Rivas and Board Member Mrs. Jennifer Fleming will present the top five awards in the College Preparatory Program of Studies to valedictorian Jordan Loftus, salutatorian Melissa Menzel, third honors Mahmoud Shahada, fourth honors Noel DeLeas, fifth honors Emily Piacerek, Board of Education members, Mr. Carlos Rivas and Mrs. Marianthe Manganello will present the top five awards in the Business Education Computer Science Program of Studies to Eric Johan Macias. Christian Ortiz. Nyla Hughes Green. Carisha Thomas. Shane Bean. Board of Education members, Ms. Shenader Guillaume and Mrs. Jennifer Fleming will present the top five awards in the Career and Technical Education Program of Studies to Leo Young. Dylan Gomez. Christian Calvo. Ethan Martinez. Chisa Torto. At this time, we will present some very special awards. Dr. Karen Baldwin, Director of Human Resources, will present the AR Toronto Award for the best all-around student of the class of 2021.
Thank you. I'm pleased to present this award tonight for the best all-around student to Mackenzie Kuntz. For extracurricular activities participation, athletic programs participation, and service to Linden High School and school spirit. Congratulations.
The Principal's Award is given to a student who stands apart as a person of character, honor, and commitment to academic excellence. this year's recipient is very special. She battled through a life-threatening illness, refusing to give up or give in. While others would have buckled, she maintained a full IB course load, bringing her computer with her to the hospital and never missing a beat. I am inspired by her strength of character and her resilience. It is nothing short of heroic. This year's award goes to Miss Melissa Menzel. Our next award recognizes students with perfect attendance, grades 9 through 12. This award is named after William McMahon, a retired language arts teacher who had perfect attendance his entire 33 years of service at Linden High School. May the following students please come forward to receive your award from our Assistant Superintendent of Schools, Mrs. Denise Cleary, Isabella Furtek. Alexander Stapkowitz. And Leo Young, not one day, Leo Young. This year, and they're all being awarded clocks, even though I don't think they really need them. Congratulations. This year, we have five retired Linden Public School faculty members with us today. They have dedicated many years of service to the Linden School District. We would like to honor them by presenting them with a diploma emeritus. The diplomas will be presented by board members, Ms. Malaysia Thomas, and by Ms. Guillaume. Will the following retirees please come forward to the podium to receive your diploma? Ms. Helena Augustiniak. Miss Rita Cruz Torres. Congratulations. Miss Patricia Gergely. Miss Juanita O'Neill. and Ms. Patricia Zenchek. Thank you for your many years of service.
Now the playing of our school alma mater. Gentlemen, please remove your caps. Graduating class, please stand. Graduates, please be seated. Parents, families, and friends, each of you have come here today for one purpose, to hear one name. At this time, it is my great honor to call forth each student of the Linden High School graduating class of 2021. Mackenzie Kuntz, Jordan Loftus, Melissa Menzel, Mahmoud Shahada, Emily Schnurkowski, Hadasha Ramirez, Pamela Bazan, Corina Acosta, Koyansola Ashukeji, Mackenzie Barrett, Danielle Brackett, Eileen Correa, Sindel Dalzon, Noel DeLeas, Chloe Elmera, Brianna Fernandez, Daniel Fernandez, Alexis
Fitz. Jason Fonseca. Landy Garcia. Yeah! Javari Gordon. Stephanie Gutierrez. Nyla Hughes Green. Ava Jarzab. Annika Labrador. Mylin Lazaro. Fahimi Mamadville. Ethan Martinez. Miriam Miranda. Nicole Monzon. Myrna Mustafa. Erica Ordonez. Emily Piacerik. Caitlin Ramos. Carolyn Ramos. Samara Razuri. Jackie Wren. Nicole Restrepo. Sierra Reyes. Ariana Salazar. Sebastian Sanchez. Jay Santa Maria. Alexander Stapkowitz. Victoria Strzowska. Carisha Thomas. Colette Vallejos. Daniela Valverde. Deja Wilson. Claudia Zero. Shirley Manessas. Wilson Ojeda. Khadija Sidamed. Joachim Ajila. Madeline Aguiar. Tyrese Akins. Monica Albello. Aaliyah Ali. Raja Ali. Jarius Allen. Giovanni Allison. Jonathan Alvarez. Kiara Alvarez. Alicia Alves. Maria Ambreen. Jeremiah Amos. Sarai Anderson. Jason Ansu. Anthony Aravallo. Josh Arrington. Pedro Batista Perez. Chrislyn Augustine. Jalen Austin. Lydia Ayaya. Benjamin Babatunde. Kylie Borchardi. Pablo Baloco. Maria Sanchez. Rock Barthelis. Ashana Brinson. Nikita Brown. Shane Bean. Edwin Beltre Fernandez. Rachel Benavides. Marcus Burles. Shatea Bowen. Jordan Boyd. Devon Matthew Boykin. Camilla Marie Boykin. Isaiah Brevard. Michael Catano. Nikolai Brummett. Alex Brzezinski. Liam Burgos. Christian Calvo. Joshua Camacho. Carl Jacob Cando. Ajane Capers. Daniel Caraballi. Janaea Cologne. Jamari Cologne. Enrique Cespedes. Shamaya Champagne. Desiree Chapman. Juliana Correa. Kanisha Charles. Gabriel Chirino. Arona Cisse. Denisha Clairvoyant. Jean Contreras. Anthony Cabeza. Isabella Correas. Kevin Coronado. Gabriel Cruz. Gabriella Cruz. Nelson Cruz. Elmer Cruz Sanchez. Karen Kubilos. Jada Puritan. Alexandra Zerwinski. Anu Alu Wapo Dada. Emanuela Dada. Lisette DeSantos. Natalie DeSouza. Masayel DeJesus. Marsha Dobris. Kimara Dorsainville. Charlene Dortelis. Isadora Dos Santos. Kalila Dunn. Brandon Duran. Imario Edwards. Matthew Ely. Giovanni Eliscar. Alan Elon. Sydney Emerson. Jerry Abel. Travis Espinal. Skyla Saray Estrada. John Fernandez. Stephen Figueroa Ramos. James Fitz Jr. Ian Fleischman. Justin Fleming. Catherine Flores. Dylan Gomez. Isaiah Franco. Jose Franco. Juan Franco Moya. Kiani Freyer. Isabella Fertek. Pierre Gabriel. Nathan Gotti. Diego Galindo Martinez. Michelle Gaston. Janaya Goforth. Vadim Goncharov. Jacob Gonzalez. Leah Gonzalez. Cornelius Darnell Goodwin George. Paulo Branda Torre. Destiny Graves. Tyrese Griffin. David Grahafa. Ana Maria Guerrero Manrique. Maria Jose Guerrero Manrique. Michael Hill. George Guillen. Macaulay Gutierrez. Anna Harris. Tamara Harrison. Gilhermie Hartman. Ania Haskins. Kadisha Henry. Maudlin Henry. Digmarie Hernandez Batista. Inique Hodge. Gavincia Housen. Ayana Hurtado. Yasmin Irving. Jeff Jeanvier. Westenley Jasmine. Cindy Jean. Natalie Jean. Stephen Janot. Darren Kissy. Ismailin Jimenez Baldera. Fernanda Abigail Jimenez. Amari Johnson. Brian Johnson. Isaiah Johnson. Jayla Gia Johnson. Jayana Joseph. Rebecca Joseph. Isaiah Keller Jenkins. Tymir Kimbrough. Isabella Kobus. Jacqueline Croc. Danny Landaverde. Robert Lane. Samantha Lang. Nigel Lattimore. Myrna Jackie LaVenture. Marilyn Lazos. Lamont Lee. Ferlangi Lewisnard. Brenna Lucard. Alexandra Lisboa. Andre Lopez. Fran Lopez. Jamir Lopez. Kevin Lopez. Ronisha Lossier. Peterson Lewis. Sandra Lewis. Destiny Martinez. Eric Macias. Felipe Macias. Miguel Macias.
Sean Mannix. Faisa Mark. Jillian Marcano. Ariante Marquez. Shamar Marshall. Rafael Martinez. Roberto Meadows. Alconi Martinez. Paola Martinez Batista. Jose Martinez Casco. Jericho Mascarenas. Angie Mata. Nassim McLeod. Ja'Kai McDougal. Tejan McDougal. Matthew McGuire. Felicia McKnight. Justice Medina. Kenneth Medina. Ethan Melendez Umanzor. Daniel Mendez. Christy Mendez. Andy Medalia. Huberman Michelle. Shetty Michelle. Tyson Miller. Jesse Munoz. Joseph Monkeo. Joshua Mondesir. Andridge Morales. Karis Morales. Gina Morales. Mia Moreau. Crystal Moreno. Kellery Moranta. Amani Mohammadi. Rajan Mohammed. Dylan Munoz Calero. Derrison Munoz Nunez. Edison Munoz Nunez. Soraya Narvaez. Kenneth Navarrete. Kenneth Neves. Amir Newcomb. Nerio Noblega. Mary Laura. Luz Nunez Rivas. Angeline O'Donnell. Elijah Oates. Dante Olds. Julian Okendo. Cassie
Orcutt. Stephanie Ordonez. Alyssa Ortega. Christian Ortiz. Emily Orzakowski. Lola Osborne. Neilani Pacheco. Oscar Pacheco. Christian Palakibe. Jaden Parham. Valeska Paraguas. Sean Patterson. Lucas Pereira. Christopher Ramos. Quentin Philippe. Janissa Pierre. Brianna Picado. Anaya Pereira. Quentin Perkins. Carter Pitts. Luis Quintana Monteverde. Grace Perez. Melissa Ramirez. Annie POTUS. Emmanuel Ramos. Isabella Ramos. Julian Ramos. Donna Ramos Aguiar. Mariana Ramos Dos Santos. Isaiah Randall. Imani Rashid. Jason Rengifo. Jonathan Rengifo. Sebastian Rodriguez. Aaron Reyes. Nicholas Riccardi. Altenise Riddick. Shania Rivera. Daenerys Rivera Massonet. Alex Rodriguez. Joey Rodriguez. Matias Rodriguez. Ashley Salas. Justin Sanabria Ortiz. Valerie Rodriguez. Jessica Lady Roman. Jonathan Romero. Brian Rosario. Sergio Rosario. Alondra Rosario Berrios. Alana Rosario Cambero. Hassan Satain. Jason Silva. Javed Singh. Nicholas Sanchez. Terry Sannon. Joanna Santa Maria. Jasmine Sarmiento Quesada. Samantha Sakaira. Miliana Seneskat. Karam Shazad. Carolina Silva. Muhammad Sultan. Kenneth Taylor. LaShawn Sneed. Kwameen Solomon. Jaheim St. Bernard. Leani Stafford. Nikhail Steed. Natalia Stepakowski. Alex Suarez. Shisa Torto. Schneider Toussaint. Carter Tucker. Christian Termitis. Vina Tai. Desmond Thomas. Khalil Thomas. Chardonnay Thompson. Winter Thompson. Zakaya Thompson. Camilla Torres. Carlos Vejerano. Steven Venegas. Julie Nelly Ulysses. Anthony Urataya. Andrew Valsin. Joel Vargas. Isabel Vasquez. Justin Vasquez. Rebecca Vasquez. Brianna Williams. Kaylin Wilson. Victoria Vornar. Khalil Wright. Caitlin Ventura. Hudson Vertis. Gerby Victor. Josh Vilford. Tabri Ward.
Daquan Waters. Dior Weaver Dooley. Angel Williams. Armani Chanel Winston. Leo Young. Richard Zach. Christian Flores Rivera. Sadly, this past November, the class of 2021 lost one of its own. Jade Essence Givens may not be here physically, however, I know she is looking down upon us this evening, and she is remembered. A chair, a cap and gown, and a diploma has been set aside to honor Jade. Please join in a moment of silence. Thank you. Jade Essence Givens, you will always be a part of the class of 2021. At this time, I would like to present to you the senior class president, Mackenzie Kuntz. Please come forward to give the farewell address.
Good evening, parents, family, friends, administration, faculty, Board of Education members, distinguished guests, and most importantly, the class of 2021. I thank you all for being here tonight to celebrate this outstanding accomplishment. It is with great honor I stand here tonight in front of you all to present tonight's farewell address and reminisce on the legacy we have created together these past 4 years. Fellow seniors, we have finally reached graduation day. It feels like just yesterday we were the small fish in the big pond that is Linden High School. As freshmen, we walked the halls of the main building, trying to understand the concept of the odd and the even sides, some of us falsely convinced by upperclassmen that there was a pool on the roof of the school, which was used by the swim team to practice. To say the least, I think it's fair to note that we have had a unique high school experience. We started off the same way as the preceding classes. That was, of course, until our world was completely flipped upside down. Like my ROTC instructors always taught me, we had to adapt, overcome, and persevere through what may very well have been the most challenging time of our lives. But we made it. And now, after it all, we find ourselves here under the painted sky and bright lights of Tiger Stadium, gathered in the same spot we were exactly 4 years ago, when both McManus and Soul eighth graders came together for the first time as the class of 2021. And as the sun is set here tonight and the natural light expires, so do our ID numbers and our time as Linden High School students. As the nighttime falls upon us, I like to think of it as a fitting end to this chapter of our lives. Similar to how the sunrise denotes the start of the day and a new beginning, a sunset indicates the completion of a cycle. The strange thing about a sunset is that we don't ever really want the sun to set. We want it to stay right on the horizon, not above or below, just right on it. The comforting sense of calmness and completion a sunset brings puts you in a state of admiration you never want to leave. In a way, this is like ending high school. Although this moment has been long awaited, I know I'm feeling this way tonight. As we know, all things must come to an end at some point, including the sunset, and then comes the dark. I think what might be so frightening about the dark for some is its mysterious nature. Ultimately, it comes down to the fear of the unknown. You don't know how your story begins or how it ends, what changes may occur, or what obstacles you may face after you leave here today. There are no instructions, and like the clear night sky, you only have a blank canvas to work with. I found a quote I would like to share with you all tonight. Life imposes things on you that you can't control, but you have the choice of how you're going to live through it. You can make the choice to show kindness in a world full of hatred. You can make the choice to be a leader in a world full of followers. You can make the choice in life to focus on the negative aspects or embrace the positive ones. You can make the choice to leave here today simply as a graduate of high school or as a young adult with the mindset that you are about to do something bigger than yourself. So, if you are one of those people who are afraid of the dark or afraid of what comes after high school, please remember that the choices you make in life will lead to your ultimate fulfillment and happiness. As we reach the conclusion of tonight's ceremony, I would just like to take a moment to thank a few people. To my fellow class officers, Vice President Emily Schnurkowski, Secretary Hadasha Ramirez, and Treasurer Pamela Bazan. Thank you for your hard work and for being the greatest team I could possibly ask for. I would also like to express my gratitude to our amazing class advisors, Ms. Marchese and Ms. Kaladiud, as well as our Vice Principal, Mr. Fakiti, and our wonderful Principal, Mrs. Hori, who have worked so diligently to make sure our high school experience was memorable. I would also like to thank Mrs. Todd, as well as Ms. Carter, for all of your support and assistance. If you all would, please come up and receive your gifts on behalf of the class of 2021. Come on up. Come on up. I know we all want to get home, so I'm going to try and wrap this up as quick as possible. Okay, continuing on. I also feel much obliged to thank my family, I'm sitting over there somewhere, to my mom, my dad, my sister Mallory, my godparents, and everyone else. I can never thank you enough. You have always taught me to stay true to myself, and I believe that that was the key to all of my successes and accolades. You are sincerely the reason I have become the person I am today, and everything I do for you all. To the teachers and staff, I think I speak on behalf of all of us when I say that you have played a key role into our growth as young adults. Thank you for your endless support and for having a tremendous impact on us all. The lessons which you have taught us will stay with us always. Finally, I would like to thank all of you, my fellow graduates. Thank you for placing the trust in me to act as a representative of our class and allowing me to have such an amazing opportunity. As your class president, I thank you for giving me the chance to have served you. I truly cannot be more grateful. As your friend, classmate, and peer, it's bittersweet to see us part, but it has been a pleasure knowing you, learning with you, and for some, growing up alongside you. As they say, once a tiger, always a tiger. Seniors, it is now that time to carry out the classic tradition of turning the tassels on our graduation caps. The turning of the tassel represents the completion of one's time in high school and signifies the earning of a diploma. Now is your chance to make sure your tassel's on the right side just in case it might be on the wrong side. Before we turn them, I want you to think about someone who helped you get here today. One of your favorite high school memories, your best friendships and relationships, or one of your greatest personal triumphs. Use it as your inspiration and motivation to move forward in your life and accomplish future endeavors. Reflect and evaluate this moment and prepare yourself for a fresh start. Your completion of high school is successful, and now it's time to take a new direction. And although the sun has set and our high school journey has come to an end, the memories will last forever. Now, if you would, please join me in turning your tassel, marking your official status as a high school graduate. Congratulations to the Linden High School class of 2021.
Parents and guests, please remain seated as students exit the stadium. At this time, I would like to ask the dignitaries to lead out the procession, followed by our 2021 graduates.